explain about the mole and mole concept. So one mole of any substance contains 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 particles. The particles can be atoms or molecules or ions or electrons or protons. So we can say that one mole of every substance contains a definite number of particles, and that definite number of particles is 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 units. We can say units also. So this is the one mole. So it can be molecule also. Here I have written atoms, molecules, ions, electrons, anything. This is one point. Similarly, one mole of any substance weight means it has weight equal to either its atomic weight or its molecular weight, or it can be its own weight. There can be its own weight. So this is one point. As you know, one mole of any substance has particles equal to 6.022 10 to the power 23. We can write here units, and it also has the same weight. That is, either it will be equal to its atomic weight or equal to its molecular weight. And this concept is nothing but this concept is called as mole concept. So mole concept may be defined as a relationship between number of particles, number of unit, to a particular mass, particular weight. Once again I am repeating, mole concept may be defined as relationship between the number of particles present in a given amount of substance. So mole is universal quantity. And suppose I say one mole of sodium metal. So its weight will be equal to 23 U. It is the atomic mass of sodium, and it will have 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 sodium atoms. So this is one mole of sodium, 23. So atomic mass of sodium is 23, and number of particles is 6.022 10 to the power 23 sodium atoms. Now other example, one mole of water. So you know water is a molecule. So molecular mass of water, hydrogen 1 into 2, 2 plus oxygen atomic mass is 16. So it will be 18. We express the units as U, small u. U stands for unified mass. Previously it was expressed in gram, but now we write U, unified mass. So one mole of water has 18 U mass, and number of particles 6.022 10 to the power 23 water molecules. So this is very unique relationship. This 23 has this much, 18 has this much. Now other case, if we take hydrogen, so one mole hydrogen, H2 gas. So H2 gas, so hydrogen molecular mass is 2, so it will be 2U, 2 gram, and it has same amount of H2 molecules. two molecules. One mole hydrogen atoms, here molecules, here atoms, one mole H. So it will be one U, and it has same number of hydrogen atoms. So this is hydrogen atoms. So this 2U, it is 1U, number of particles remain same. So the point is, irrespective of the weight, irrespective of the masses, the number of particles will remain same. And this all, you know, relationship is called a mole concept. Next part, numerical point of view. So this is the first formula, and it is number of moles in a substance is equal to amount of substance. So amount of substance will be given, and it has to be divided by its atomic weight or molecular weight. So it can be an element, it can be a molecule. Suppose I am giving a question, calculate number of moles present in a sample of water weighing 90 gram. Calculate the number of moles present in a sample of water weighing 90 gram. So what is, you have to calculate the number of moles, and the weight given is 90 gram. So for this, first of all, you have to calculate the molecular weight of water. So we'll start first step, molecular weight of water. You know water formula is H2. What is molecular weight? The addition of atomic weights. So it will be equal to hydrogen, you know, hydrogen has 1 and multiplied by 2. Oxygen atomic weight is 16. So here 16 plus 2, it will be equal to 18 U. This is the first step. This has to be followed. So this will be the first step. Now coming to second step, number of moles. So moles, number of moles in 90 gram water is equal to, so this 90 has been given mass, so 90 upon, here it is 18, so 19 upon 18, how much? It will be equal to 5 moles. So this is the way to calculate. This is the first step, this is the second step, and thus we can calculate the number of moles in a given substance. So here we have to calculate the atomic and this molecular weight by adding the atomic weights. In case of an element, if the substance is an element, then we divide by its atomic weight. Next question, in which there is the element, calculate the number of moles present in a sample of sodium metal weighing 40 grams. So, you know, sodium is a metal. So, we have to take the atomic weight. So, first step, how we solve? First step, atomic weight of sodium is equal to 23 U. This step has to be written, because in CBSE or all boards, marks are given for this step. It is fixed. Now second, number of moles present term sodium. Number of moles present in 40 grams sodium. So what we'll do? Then we write here 40. 40 upon this 23. 40 upon 23. Now you have to divide it. So see, it will not be equal to 2. It will be less than 2 because it is 40 years. So here it will be 1. And let's divide. So it will be 1.73 moles. 1.73 moles. So this is the way how we determine the number of moles given in any substance. Other way, second formula. Actually, formulas are nothing but just the change in the value, change in the given quantity. So here the in other form, if we want to calculate the amount of substance, what is the amount of substance, and this can be obtained when we have the number of moles and atomic weight or molecular weight. Once again I am repeating, if we have been given, so this number of moles will have to be given and atomic weight or molecular weight. So these two quantities have to be given, then we can calculate the amount of substance. See, the numericals are very much simple. Point is that you have to focus, think logically. It's not chemistry, but it is a part of mathematics, mathematical approach. So if very simple question, calculate the amount of substance or amount of CO2, amount of CO2 in 2 moles sample. 2 moles sample. So sample given is 2 moles. So first again, two steps. First we have to calculate the molecular weight. Molecular weight of CO2. So molecular weight, what is molecular weight? The sum of atomic weights. So carbon atomic weight is 12 and O2, oxygen. Oxygen has atomic weight 16 and it is 2. So what we write? 16 into 2. So here 12 plus 32. So it will be equal to 44U. It will be equal to 44U. Now coming to second part. So this is the formula. So number of moles. So here it is. How much? Number of moles is equal to 2 and its molecular weight is 44. So 2 into 44 is equal to 88 gram. Here, so thus we can calculate the this number of moles, amount of substance. So we can change the formula accordingly. Formula has to be changed accordingly. What you want to calculate. Similarly, atomic weight or molecular weight can be calculated by knowing these two. So this is simple, replication or changing of the formula. Again, next very important numerical, and this is the third one, weight of an atom or molecule. How to calculate the weight of an atom or molecule? So it is very simple also as previous ones. So if you want to determine the weight of an atom, so we have to give an atomic weight. If you want to determine the weight of a molecule, then we have to give a molecular weight, and it has to be divided by a fixed number, that is 6.02 to 10 to the power 23. Now I am writing a question. Question is that what will be the weight of an atom carbon having atomic weight 12 u. So it's very simple. Again, so what we need, that weight of carbon atom, weight of carbon atom is equal to, here it is, atomic weight 12. So 12 upon 6.022 10 to the power 23. This is very simple. Now I am giving a very important trick. I have seen large number of students, they struggle in this very basic numerical. So as here it has been given 10 to the power 23, so don't touch it, leave here as it is, because it is only one, no need of doing anything. So simply here, when we have to divide this quantity to this, so first write here, it is in plus, it will go upside, so it will be 10 to the power minus 23, and here it is u, so it will be u, u is also equal to gram, so here it will be gram. Now coming to this, if it is 6, then it will be equal to 2, but it is 6.022, it means it will be slightly less than 2. So here 1, and just first plus there is 0, second plus there is 2, so it will be less than 2, so it will be 1.9, or more accurately 1.99 grams. So this is the way how to calculate the weight of an atom. Similarly, we can calculate a weight of molecule also. So for that, we have to given the molecular mass. So if we divide molecular mass, then we will get the weight of a molecule. To next numerical, what will be the weight in gram of 2 moles of HCl? 2 moles, hydrogen chloride is 2 moles. So first, we will calculate the molecular mass of HCl. So first step, again, molecular mass of HCl. So molecular mass is sum of atomic weights. So hydrogen has atomic mass of 1. Chlorine 35.5 u. So on adding, you will get the 36.5 u. Now second part, weight of 2 moles of HCl. So it will be nothing. So it will be 2 into 36.5. How much? It will be 73 gram. So you can imagine the solving numerical problems is very simple, but there is little presence of mind and little memory has to be required, because atomic weight has to be remembered. Atomic weight has to be remembered. You cannot solve any numerical, either in physics or chemistry or even mathematics, without learning the formula. So it's a secret point that you have to learn all the basics. If you don't know basics, you cannot solve the question.